Welcome back to All Things Considered from NPR News. I'm Linda Wertheimer. Long before Twilight or Gossip Girl dominated the tween reading lists, there was one series from the 1980s that set a high bar for hits in young adult literature, Sweet Valley High. It's been 10 years since author Francine Pascal wrote the last book. Now she's written an update called Sweet Valley Confidential, and the original series is about to be a major motion picture. NPR's Rachel Syme examines why the Sweet Valley phenomenon endures.
If you've never read a Sweet Valley High book, this is all you need to know. It's the story of two blonde twins, Elizabeth and Jessica Wakefield. They are queens of their school. Elizabeth is the good one. Jessica is the evil one, always trying to sabotage her sweet sister. It is a morality play, albeit one soaked in Aquanet.
It always surprised me how alive this series was.
That's Sweet Valley creator Francine Pascal.
I would meet women in their late 20s, 30s, and when they found out who I was, they became 16 again.
And it's for these women that Pascal wanted to revisit the twins in a new book. In it, the twins are now 27 and confronting very adult problems.
I just felt that would be a lot of fun for them to see what happened when these marvelous characters that they loved so much became their age.
One of those early readers was Oscar-winning screenwriter Diablo Cody. She's working on a movie adaptation of the original Sweet Valley series. She says it's her dream project.
As like a kind of a mousy, plain little girl growing up in the Midwest, I thought the greatest thing I could aspire to was to be blonde and beautiful and to have this kind of alter ego who was my best friend and live in California.
Cody's film will be the second screen adaptation of the series. It was a hit TV show in the mid-1990s.
Growing up as a twin, it's like that's the number one birthday present you get is a Sweet Valley High book.
That's Brittany Daniel, who played Jessica Wakefield in the TV show opposite her twin sister Cynthia.
We grew up reading those books, and wherever we would go as kids, people would be like, yeah, it's the Sweet Valley High twins. And we're like, ha ha ha. And then finally one day we got a call about the audition, and it was like, oh my God, this is like the perfect role for us.
Daniel says that even their real-life personalities were the same.
Like, my sister Cynthia is a little bit more like Elizabeth, soft-spoken, and I'm a little more, I guess, outgoing and aggressive, maybe.
The question of whether you are more of a Jessica, evil, or an Elizabeth, goody-two-shoes, is the heart of the Sweet Valley series. Again, screenwriter Diablo Cody.
Francine told me that girls would write to her and tell her how much they love Jessica, but the girls themselves, she could tell, were Elizabeths because they're writing to their favorite author, and, you know, which is not something Jessica would do. She felt that her fans were mostly Elizabeths who wanted to be Jessica.
The good twin, bad twin theme, the hormonal drama, the endless summer, it was all catnip for teenagers. But Pascal says that for her, the books had a deeper meaning.
One of the reasons I wrote Sweet Valley the way I did it was because I wanted girls to drive the action. Up until then, in all those romance books, the girl was waiting to be kissed to wake up Sleeping Beauty. And in Sweet Valley, those girls do drive the action.
Pascal says she's not sure whether the new book will be the end of the Wakefield twins saga, but fans can expect the movie version of Sweet Valley High sometime next year. For NPR News, I'm Rachel Syme.